Hi there. Aren't you going to speak to me? I'm waiting to hear you say hi. That's better. You know who this is, don't you? This is King Louie. Ooh, 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 a hooba-dooba-dooba-doo. You remember me from Jungle Book? I thought you would. But let me ask you this. Did you know that Robin Hood and I were friends long, long ago? Honest, I knew Rob almost as well as I know you. And you know what pals you and I have been ever since the movie Jungle Book. Well, let me tell you a secret that no one knows except you and me. King Louie and Robin Hood were friends long ago. If you believe in make-believe, you'll find that this is so. They used to hang around together like a set of twins. That's the way that they became the very best of friends. You would see those cats together all the time. If you'd see one, you'd know the other wasn't far behind. Like two peas inside a pot, or two roosters on one lightning rod. No greater friendship ever stood than King Louie and Robin Hood. King Louie and Robin Hood were friends long ago. If you believe in make-believe, you'll find that this is so. They used to hang around together like a set of twins. That's the way that they became the very best of friends. One day, while Rob and his merry men were having some time off, Rob decided to go pay a visit to the little red schoolhouse where he had gone to school as a little boy. He remembered how they used to sing and play and how happy they were all the time. Boy, was he excited. He even practiced on some of the songs as he walked along the little pathway that led to the school. Mary had a little lamb, oh, boobie-doobie-doo. As he got closer, he heard the children singing, but there was no laughter in their voices. They didn't sound happy, not like they did when he was in school. And the reason they were unhappy was because the old mean sheriff had taken all the money away from their mamas and daddies. They had very little food at home, and no warm clothes to wear at all. And even on Christmas Day, what do you think? Even Santa Claus didn't have enough money to bring them any toys. Robin Hood felt so sad as he stood outside the window of the little red schoolhouse and listened.
Merry men, merry men, make the world
put a smile on every face. Make the world a better place.
Merry men, merry men. Everyone needs a friend.
Love thy neighbor and you'll see just how friendly friends can be. Fill your heart with love, it's so much fun to do.
It feels so good,
and it looks so good, especially on you.
Merry men, merry men, make the world laugh again.
Put a smile on every face, make the world a better place.
Merry men, merry men, make the world laugh again.
Do you know what most little boys and girls ask about when I'm telling them the story of Robin Hood? They want to know all about his home, where he lived, and how it looked. Well, close your eyes and imagine you're going on a long trip with me. Are your eyes closed? Okay, here we go to Sherwood Forest.
Far away from worldly cares is Sherwood Forest. Oh, where life is so at ease, you barely feel the breeze as it rustles up the leaves in time to hear a song or two. That old man Meadowlark wrote just for you. Every night the stars come out and lift the evening veils of shade. You can hear the crickets saying, man, we've got it made. When the crocus and the rosebud say good morning to the dawn, something's wrong with you if this don't turn you on. Now would you like to come and visit Sherwood Forest someday soon? We'd love to have you come. There's lots and lots of room. Though it sounds expensive, you don't have to be a millionaire. Just close your eyes and dream, and you'll be there. Sherwood Forest someday soon. We'd love to have you come. Why, there's lots and lots of room. Though it sounds expensive, you don't have to be a millionaire. Just close your eyes and dream. Close your eyes and dream.
By now, I suppose you know all about how Robin Hood took from the rich and gave to the poor. Well, what I want you to understand is Robin Hood and his merry men were the good guys. You see, the mean old sheriff was going around taxing all of the poor people and taking all of their money. Well, Rob didn't like it one bit, and he was really mad. So what Rob did was merely take the money back from the king and give it back to the poor people who were Rob's friends. But for those of you who haven't seen Walt Disney's Robin Hood, maybe I'd better tell you a little more about him.
Long years ago, fella named Robin Hood used to rob the rich, was every chance he could. You shouldn't get me wrong, because it was no square. With his trusty bow and arrow, he could part your hair. His brother was Little John, another was Allen Dale. 140 more, together they hit the trail. They would scamper through the forest to the Blue Boar Inn. Missy Eden told them where they should be. again. He took from the rich man, oh, gave it to the poor man. Had a fear for no man, only for his chick whose name was Marianne. And here is a switcheroo, a Rob Warner's loyal crew. King Richard forgave them all, and here's what they had to do. They became his Royal Rangers and were very good. So that ends our little tale of Robin Hood. Robin Hood, Little John, Robin Hood, Fire Tuck, Sam Buterin. Man, and he gave it to the poor man. Had a fear for no man, only for his chick, whose name was Marianne. And here is a switcheroo, a problem to his loyal crew. King Richard forgave them all, here's what they had to do. They became his Royal Rangers and were very good. So that ends our little tale of Robin Hood. Robin Hood, Little John, woo! Robin Hood, yeah, get it, baby. Oh, Little John, King Louis.
One day, while Rob and his merry men were having some time off, Rob decided to go pay a visit to the little red schoolhouse where he had gone to school as a little boy. He remembered how they used to sing and play and how happy they were all the time. Boy, was he excited. He even practiced on some of the songs as he walked along the little pathway that led to the school. Mary had a little lamb, oh, boo-ba-doo-ba-doo. As he got closer, he heard the children singing, but there was no laughter in their voices. They didn't sound happy, not like they did when he was in school. And the reason they were unhappy was because the old mean sheriff had taken all the money away from their mamas and daddies. They had very little food at home, and no warm clothes to wear at all. And even on Christmas Day, what do you think? Even Santa Claus didn't have enough money to bring them any toys. Robin Hood felt so sad as he stood outside the window of the little red schoolhouse and listened.
Merry Merry.
Put a smile on every face, make the world a better place.
Merry men, merry men, everyone needs a friend.
Love thy neighbor and you'll see just how friendly friends can be. Fill your heart with love, it's so much fun to do.
It feels so good,
and it looks so good, especially on you.
Merry men, merry men, make the world laugh again.
Put a smile on every face, make the world a better place.
Merry men, merry men, make the world laugh again.
The worst thing about being a merry man is that you're not always as merry as you'd like to be. And if you miss the one you love, it's no fun to be alone at all. Well, Robin had never gotten over being in love with Maid Marian. Of course, he was old and so was she. But you know something? Love grows up inside of us. And as we grow older, so does love. The bigger we get, the bigger love gets. And the better it gets, too.
Love, it seems like only yesterday. You were just a child at play. Now you're all grown up inside of me. Oh, how fast those moments flee. Once we watched a lazy world go by. Now the days seem to fly. Life is brief, but when it's gone, love goes on and on. Once we watched a lazy world go by. Now the days seem to fly. Oh, life. But when it's gone, love goes on and on.
By now, I suppose you know all about how Robin Hood took from the rich and gave to the poor. Well, what I want you to understand is Robin Hood and his merry men were the good guys. You see, the mean old sheriff was going around taxing all of the poor people and taking all of their money. Well, Rob didn't like it one bit, and he was really mad. So what Rob did was merely take the money back from the king and give it back to the poor people who were Rob's friends.